Welcome to the first module on teaching as research. My name is Bennett Goldberg. I'm a professor of physics and director of STEM education initiatives in the office of the provost of Boston University. Together with my colleague Rick Campa, associate dean of the graduate school and professor of wildlife ecology at Michigan State University, we have created this module for you. Let's start first by talking about what is teaching as research, or TAR. The basic idea of teaching as research is to apply the process of inquiry to teaching and learning. The purpose of doing a TAR project is to translate the skills you already have as researchers into a new space of teaching and learning. The outcome of completing a teaching as research project is to help transform you into becoming a reflective practitioner, someone who looks at their teaching and says, "What might improve student learning?" and then can apply a process of inquiry to know what works and to improve their teaching. Let's unpack these statements a bit more. Formally, the CERTL statement is, "Teaching as research involves the deliberate, systematic, and reflective use of research methods to develop and implement teaching practices that advance the learning experiences and outcomes of students and teachers." So in a TAR project, you develop a hypothesis. You review and explore what the literature says. You refine your hypothesis. You develop metrics and measurements to guide a particular intervention and social experiment that you design for the classroom. You then collect data and analyze that data and use your results to inform your teaching and hopefully student learning. It's the same kinds of things we do in our research. In TAR, you will be applying your existing research skills and develop new skills applied to a new area with new challenges. You likely already know what a full cycle of inquiry is and have done it yourself in many small and large research efforts. But you may not yet know how to analyze social science or learning science data, nor how the data can be used to form what we call knowledge claims around evidence or evidence-based instruction. Finally, the outcomes, becoming a reflective instructor, to help you teach the way you want to teach, to be efficient in the development and improvement of effective courses for your students, to become part of a new generation of STEM faculty, excellent at both research and teaching, someone who can utilize the value of diversity in the classroom and can apply inquiry to improve student learning outcomes and can be a creative member of learning communities in both research and teaching. Now that we've talked about what teaching as research is, before we get started, let's discuss a few things about what it isn't. Education research is a large and dynamic field of research using social science tools to deeply understand teaching and learning at all levels. It is rigorous, peer-reviewed, and scholarly, like any other field of research. TAR is not educational research. It isn't the scholarship of teaching and learning, or SOTL. Generally, TAR projects are introductory and exploratory. They allow you to learn how to improve teaching without the intention of producing peer-reviewed scholarly output. TAR projects typically have small numbers of students or small interventions, and are not necessarily approved by the IRB or Institutional Review Board for Human Subjects Research. Try to think of your TAR project as a first experience in inquiry in teaching and learning. Lastly, teaching as research doesn't always have to be applied to traditional classroom settings. Together with teaching as research, CERTL's core ideas include learning communities and learning through diversity. So it's perfectly all right to design and implement teaching as research projects around the functional components of a learning community, for example, or how to implement learning through diversity.